Howdy, my name is Derek Henry, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can supercharge Outlook, making it so much easier and quicker to do common tasks using, of all things, Excel. Now, why would you do that? Well, Excel has a lot of power. It integrates really well with Outlook, and it gives you this great canvas with which to work where it can handle a lot of data very efficiently. I'll give you a few examples here, and we'll go through 10 specific ways that you can save a lot of time, dozens, if not hundreds of hours a year. Now, the first one, we're going to leverage my inbox here, okay? A lot of people tell me they spend a lot of time trying to get to inbox zero where they're filing their emails or deleting them and going through them. We're gonna automate that process in two ways. One, it's gonna take a similarity index between the email subject line and the different email folders that you have set up. And you can set some preset rules very much like the Outlook rules, okay? So the first thing we wanna do is run a macro called file email messages. Okay, we're gonna use my test account here. And what it's gonna do is export all of the emails into Excel in this grid that you're seeing right here with the subject and the to line and all the things here. And it's gonna give a recommended or suggested folder to file it in. Notice most of these have a suggestion here, and that's either based on that similarity index or these filing rules that you can preset. So notice the sender, the domain, what it contains, the recipients, any attachment names contains, here's the folder we want to put it in. And that's pretty common, right? A lot of people will do this with Outlook rules, but here's the one big difference. This doesn't file them before you ever miss what it might have been saying. It's a suggestion. We can also say what folders we want to ignore as well as subfolders. Do we want to append something to the subject and compare that if you're getting a lot of systematic emails? Do we want to avoid or ignore the flagged ones? And are there words we want to ignore, like a or the or an or to or some of the real small common words that we don't want to get any false positives? Okay, and what it's going to do is every time it's going to export all of your active folders, because if you're like me and you're adding them constantly for clients you work with, you want that to be updated. Okay, so we can toggle through this, just press the alt and down key so that you can make changes to that. Notice that a few of these, it didn't put anything in there. That's fine. Maybe we just want to leave those in our inbox. And notice it ignored the flagged one. That's intentional. I use flagging all the time to make sure that I'm not missing things and automatically filing them. But let's say we're good here and there's no changes we want to make. We're just going to run that same macro again. Again, keep that same email box, because if you have multiple, you might want to do this. Notice that it's filing everything for us, right? It might take you an hour to a week to do this like it does me. The other thing it's gonna do, after it takes those 105, sorry, I thought it was only 50, it's gonna say, do you wanna hide this sheet? And the idea is that you keep this as a template with those filing rules as something you wanna reuse, and then you keep this as kind of a record. You can hide it if you want to, okay? So I'd usually recommend doing it. So that's the first one. That easily saves me a couple hours a week because I try to keep my inbox clean and on top of my tasks. Now, if you like Outlook rules instead of this approach, keep in mind, Outlook rules are gonna file things without you necessarily seeing them. I don't particularly love that. I wanna be able to see those. I don't want them to be filed as soon as they come in. I don't get a chance to even see them, right? But you can do this, and when you set this up, you run it the first time, it'll create this sheet, the one you're seeing right here. It'll be blank, it won't have any rules here unless you already have some set up. If you have some set up, it'll look just like this. You know, got a test rule here, high importance, no exceptions. So you set the name of the rule, and that's your unique identifier, okay? So, you know, you might want to give that some consideration. But you can set up to 5 conditions. You can set up to 5 separate actions. Normally people just do one, like move a folder or flag it or set the importance or something. And you can even have exceptions. So do this unless it contains a specific text or whatever that might be. You can have 5 of those right here as well. So once you set this up, you can choose to either add it or update it or delete it. Or it might be one that's read-only. There are some actions that you have to do within the Outlook user interface. You can't do through an integration like this. But this gives you a way to update those rules in bulk. And maybe you want to mix and match these. Take that email filing approach. Take this approach and mix and match them for things that are high risk, low risk. But the reason I like using Excel for this is because you can copy that whole row and paste and just make small tweaks to it. Or even better, link it to other parts of a workbook. So that's the second way. Now, the third thing that you can do is do a bulk edit of all of those email folders, right? So you can kind of see these in mine. I've got a whole bunch of these that are set up. We can refresh that if we want to, or we can add, we can delete, we can update those. So if you're setting these up on the front end, or if you're like me, I had some other templates that would add client folders as they got assigned to me over time. You can use this to manage that in bulk, make some changes, rename them, add, delete, etc. Or maybe you want to transfer those from an old computer to a new one. Now, normally that's going to follow Outlook from the Exchange, but maybe you're at a new company, maybe you're setting up a new email address, and you want to keep a very similar set of folders. This is a good way to do that efficiently. And what it'll do is export all those parent folders so you have that relationship with them, just in case you want to give it a parent, not just the inbox. So here's that old parent. You can put the old folder name and then a new parent, new folder name. So if you want to make adjustments, you could do that. The fourth thing you do is export your emails. Okay? So what we can do here, I did this earlier before because I knew I was going to file all of those, right? You have the ability to say for a particular folder, do we want to export within a range? So let me show you what this looks like. I'm actually going to rename this. We're going to export all of our emails, okay, for the same test account. Okay, so what we're able to do is define which folders do we want to export for. It tells us how many messages are in each one, just in case we want to keep that in part of our, just to consider that when we're exporting. I'm going to change that right there so we have, don't know why, oh, is that, maybe it's text. There we go. So we've got a filter start and end date. It usually defaults to about a month, just so you don't export everything from the beginning of time, because that might take a long time. But all you're going to do is put yes here. And once you do this, if we said yes in the inbox, maybe we want to do the same thing for one of these other folders here. So once we do that, we can just run this again, same email account. It's going to warn you, it might take a long time depending on how many messages you're going to export. But once it's done, it's going to export them for you. Now, this didn't give us anything because we did not put a very big date range. So maybe we want to do that. Okay, maybe we want to put in a date range of a lot longer than just a few days ago. Let's put in 2019. There's not that many emails in here, so this shouldn't matter. We'll put that right there. Okay, so let's export these again now that we have a little bit of a better date range in here. There we go. So why might you do this? Well, if you're keeping up with like a ticketing email box, or if there's some reason that you want to open these, then you can absolutely do that. Now, here's the cool thing. Whatever line you are on, let's say we want to open one of these, okay? There's another macro with an add-in called the email picker, and option O here is going to open that based on that email ID. And this came in from another box here. Let me open it here. So notice this is one where I had a bunch of my schedule emailed to me automatically because I was not very good about keeping up with my calendar back in the day. But this gives you a way to export your emails very quickly. Now, number five, maybe you send a lot of messages that are very, very consistent, very structured. They look the same. Maybe you're just emailing a file or two to different people that you're working with. When you first run this one called Create Send Email Messages, it'll build this sheet and then you just fill it in. Well, my approach is to take this and link it to specific inputs. Like you're seeing right here, you've got all this stuff up here. Maybe you're just linking it to this particular cell or something else. The idea is that the file names, the subject, maybe even the body, when you want to send it, maybe these things are all linked so that you don't have to update anything other than that date, maybe one other thing. But we can put the two, the carbon copy, maybe even a BCC, which email address do you want to send from, etc. You can set all these things up and either send immediately or just create them to review them, or maybe you want to send at a specific time. This helps you do it. Now, let's say you want to send a tailored message. This is very basic. You know, idea is there's not much text. It's really more about alerts and sending files. If you want to send a tailored message, say it's an invoice or maybe it's a letter, almost like a Christmas card, this next option gives you the ability to do that, called email merge. So who are you going to send to? CC, BCC, which of your addresses is it from if you have multiple? What's that subject going to be? Again, maybe that's going to be linked to other cells. What this lets you do is attach a message template. Okay, so we've got a message template here. We can even have a path to a message if you wanted to put all of the tailored messages. So once it's kind of done a finer place, and what it's going to do is take all of these yellow fields up here. You can use as many as you want to the right, and it's going to replace them. So see how it's got these in brackets? You can put whatever text up there. That's the find, and whatever's in the rows below in that column, it's going to replace that for each row. So in this first one, it'll look for the letter date within these brackets and replace it with April 10th. If there's other rows, it's going to do that same thing, and it'll create that template, save it into a folder if you want it to, attach it to an email, or put the body of that in the text of the email. So it gives you a great, really, really cost-effective way to do this when normally you might need really specific software. All right, next thing. What if we want to manage our appointments in bulk? This is something I do all the time with a couple of kids who are very active in their different activities. This gives you an example of what you could do with that, kind of a fun example. When you run this the first time, it's going to export a blank sheet, or you can leverage it to export a date range of your calendar. And then it lets you fill these in. So the date, the start time, etc. You can use formulas to make this really efficient, like I did with the calendar of all my kids' activities. I was able to take about 1,000 individual appointments of pick them up, drop them off, early dismissal day, holidays, etc. And it's not always the same location, so I can't just use recurring appointments. And even if I did, it'd be dozens of them. Well, I took the school's calendar, I made a template out of that and said, here's where the holidays are, and using lookups, I can make that schedule of 1,000 appointments in just a few minutes. And then I can take that, I can use this and take an approach just like this one. So we're just searching for the word appointment. You can say, hey, do we want to import the contents? Of course we do. And very quickly, all of those are either added or updated, or maybe you're going to delete them. So if we look at the results of that, notice that they're automatically added to my calendar, right? And if we wanted to delete them, so it shows us it was added, but if we want to delete, we can do that as well. And with the beauty of Excel is copy and fill down, or using formulas, using find and replace, filtering and sorting. That's what makes it so powerful. So if we wanted to make that change, same thing. So that's going to say, hey, those are all deleted. So in just a couple of seconds, we added a bunch of appointments and deleted them without touching Outlook. Pretty cool. And you can do the same thing with tasks. In a moment, we'll look at contacts. So doing things in bulk, definitely one of the efficiency approaches I take. You can do the same thing with all those categories. I'm big on keeping things categorized and having different colors. I recommend if you do this, be consistent amongst your team. But if you want to take that approach, this is a way to add, edit, delete in bulk, very much like the other things we've looked at. We looked at emails a minute ago, and we looked at appointments. What if you combine them with meetings? We can take that same approach. So we can set up a whole bunch of these at the exact same time. I honestly usually use this with just one or two. And when I've been responsible for meetings like finance committee at church, great example, we would send out several different files. There'd be an agenda for this month, there'd be financials for this month, and then there would be minutes for last month. Well, those are all very consistently named, so I could link all of the file names and some of the other things like the date and the time of the meeting to an input date that drives everything. So all I'm really doing is coming into this file, changing that date, all these things update, and I can just press send. That's the way I think. I'm that lazy so that I can do more impactful things. A couple other examples here, managing your contacts, right? So if I wanted to add these people that are characters from some of my favorite movies, we can do this very, very quickly, very much like the approach we took with adding the appointments, right? So what category, all these different fields. If you're gonna switch jobs, I highly recommend exporting all those contacts, and then you can take the same approach to do that and then import them to whatever your new company is going to use. Most likely they're going to use Outlook, right? So this gives you a way to do that very quickly, or maybe you need to export an updated list of contacts for sending out maybe Christmas cards or something. This gives you a way to do that. And then lastly here, you have the ability to do in bulk edit, add, or delete your contact groups. So once we've added those contacts, then we can say, here are the groups that we want to use for that. So maybe you have a group of people you play cards with, or friends, or your kids' friends, or whatever. It could be work contacts. I try to keep these things organized so I can easily send out a message to a group and not have to worry about spelling things right, etc. So lots of tools that you can use. The key is to do things in bulk and reuse your thinking. Those are going to save you so much time, whether you take this approach or anything else. But if you want to try out all of the different tools we walked through today, please hit up the link in the comments below. Try it out for free. And if you like that, and if you want to save a couple hundred hours a year or more, there you go. If you like this video, please give it a like, please add a comment, share with your friends, of course, subscribe so you don't miss out on other great content. Thank you for watching. Have an awesome rest of your day.